Hi, I'm Dane, and today we're going to be taking an in-depth look at two different water pumps that I've been using for 2 years each. Let's review some of the specifications of these two pumps, and this will give us a good chance to give them a cleaning as well. The first pump we'll be looking at is the VivoSun 800. The VivoSun is an AC-powered pump compared to the second pump we'll be looking at, which is DC-powered. AC-powered pumps are a more basic style of pump. You just plug it into the wall and off it goes. Specifications for the VivoSun 800 include 800 gallons per hour maximum flow rate, which we won't be measuring, but we will be measuring the power consumption in watts. It claims to have 24 watts, and we'll also be measuring the head height. VivoSun claims to be able to pump to 3 meters, which is just under 10 feet. The second pump we'll be looking at is the Orleshi DC5000. As suggested by the name, the Orleshi is a DC-powered pump. Common advertised differences between DC and AC-powered pumps are that DC-powered pumps run quieter, more efficiently, so you should save money in electric costs over the life of the pump. They do cost more upfront, but they're also able to be controlled. This control simply changes the power that goes into the pump, but because it can vary, we call it a variable speed pump, we'll be testing this DC pump at different levels of power consumption that you can change with the controller. I'm kind of stoked that the Orleshi doesn't give the full picture of its specifications. It says that it will draw 40 watts, but it's a variable speed pump, so there's a lower level, and I'm anxious to find what that is today. And it says that it pumps to 4 meters, which is about 13 feet. But again, that's going to vary because this pump can change. So I'm excited to see what the actual ranges are for this pump. Now that both pumps are nice and cleaned up, let's put them through some tests. The first thing we're going to test is how much power these pumps are actually consuming. To measure the watts, we'll be using a simple watt meter that I picked up off of Amazon. First up is the VivoSun 800. This pump runs at a constant 21.6 watts by my measurement. To test the power consumption of the Orleshi DC5000, we'll be testing the watt draw at various levels of constant flow. To start, we'll do the lowest flow rating at 101. As you can see, the lowest watt draw for the Orleshi is 9.8 watts. That's pretty low. As we increase power to the pump, we will test next at 105 and we get 15 watts. 110, 22.9 watts. 115, 33.7 watts. And finally, at its maximum flow rate, power, everything, the Orleshi will draw 44.8 watts. The second test we'll be putting our two pumps through is static head height. Here's a brief explanation of what static head height is. Imagine a pump with a long tube attached. We turn that pump on, it starts pumping water, and we hold the end of that tube. So it's a hose, right? If we put the end of that tube right at the surface of the water, that would be considered 0 head feet. As we raise the end of that tube up, we would expect the flow rate to decrease. That's because there's an increase in pressure from the water in that tube. As you might expect, at some point, that water will cease to flow. That means that the pressure of the pump is equal to the pressure of the water pushing down on the pump inside the tube, and the water is sitting static. That is what we call our static head height, and that's what we'll be measuring today. Head height is definitely an outdoor test, so let's bundle up and head outside in Colorado in December. The setup for this test is quite simple. It's just a fabric tape measure strung from the bottom of my deck to the top. And at the bottom, it's clamped down to a water basin, and it'll be starting at the surface of the water. To measure the actual head height, I'll have to be pumping water up, go up to the top of the deck, might have to get on a ladder, and see where the water stops flowing, and then take that measurement. Similar to the power consumption test, we'll be testing the VivoSun's static head height first. The VivoSun 800, after 2 years of use, has a static head of 8 feet. It's important to remember that static head height is not usable head height. The pump flows no water at 8 feet, so you have to use this pump for applications that are under that. To test the Orleshi DC5000, we'll be doing the same intervals that we used for the power consumption. Static head height at the lowest power consumption for the Orleshi is 7'10". Going up from there at the 105 power level, it was 10'10". 110 provided 13'9" of static head. Then we get to 115. Well, we had already surpassed what the manufacturer said that the pump could pump at its middle range. So I didn't account for having to go up this high. I'm a little afraid of heights, so I'm guesstimating the rest of this. At 115, it was at least 15 feet of static head. And from extrapolation, each interval of 5 seemed to give 3 feet. So this pump might actually be able to pump up to 18 to 20 feet static head, which far surpasses its manufacturer's specifications. To wrap up this video, I thought it'd be a good idea to put the results in a form that we can really understand. Cold, hard, cash. If you get the VivoSun 800 and run it all day, every day, it will cost you roughly $32 a year to run that pump. To compare the two pumps, we'll have to use the static head height. The VivoSun pumps at 8 feet static head, and the Orleshi at its lowest setting, 101, is just about 8 feet as well. If you were to run this Orleshi for an entire year at its lowest setting, it would cost $15 a year. It would take just under 3 years of constant use to pay for the initial cost difference in a DC pump over this equivalent AC pump. But that is assuming that you're only using the DC pump at its lowest flow and you don't care that it has feed modes or wave modes or anything like that, which it does. You might be thinking at this point that I'm all about the DC pumps and hating on the AC pumps. But the truth is, I have more AC pumps in my collection than I do DC pumps. And that's because they are simple to use. They're really cheap up front, and if you use them for periodic tasks, like moving water from one place to another, the electricity cost is negligible. So what is my takeaway from today's experiment? DC pumps are what you want for full-time circulation pumps. They're much more energy efficient, and they are quieter. If your application is periodic, like moving water from a bucket to a reservoir or something of that nature, then an AC pump seems to be the way to go. There you go, problem solved. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something. I know I did through this process. If you're interested in learning more about me or what I do, check out my website, www.fishfacefarmgj.com. While there, you can learn about our Plant Tracks hydroponic planters. Hydroponics for DIYers.